Hey guys, I'm back with the results of another hair growth experiment. This time I spent 6 months using a rosemary and castor oil solution applied overnight alongside microneedling every 10 days. My progress pictures are taken in artificial light under two conditions, either with a freshly shaved head or with exactly 7 weeks of growth since shaving. My experiments so far have failed to reverse the trend of losing my hair, which I've been tracking since 2019, and I have several other videos documenting the experiments I've tried to date. So why did I choose rosemary oil? It has some research behind it which states that it's as effective as a 2% minoxidil solution. This 2015 paper had two groups of 50 men assigned to either rosemary oil or 2% minoxidil. Neither saw improvements after 3 months, but at 6 months, they had very similar levels of growth as judged by hair count. For reference, at baseline, they had either stage 2 or stage 3 hair loss on the Norwood scale, whereas myself, I'm now closer to a stage 4. While I appreciate the honesty of a y-axis starting at 0, you can't really see what's going on here. So adding in the actual numbers, you can see there's no change at 3 months and only a 5% increase in hair count for rosemary oil at 6 months and less than 2% increase for minoxidil, though that group happened to have a denser hair count to start with. As for the method, a 1 mL solution was applied twice a day at 12-hour intervals. When I've previously read up on topical solutions, a lot of the online advice is just to leave it on for 15 or 20 minutes and then wash it out, whereas what they're trying here is closer to ensuring that the solution is always on the scalp. I used 250 drops of rosemary oil in a 50 ml bottle with castor oil to make up the rest. I applied 1 mL in the evening and left it on overnight, meaning 5 drops per application. A few people have commented that this is on the strong side, and I should say that I've had absolutely no side effects or skin irritation from using a solution of this strength. As for castor oil, its properties allow for more of a cleansing of the scalp to facilitate growth rather than directly contributing to it. Microneedling is also more of a complementary or adjunct therapy, shown to improve the effectiveness of topical solutions by up to 8 times when used before application. This review paper noted improvements when paired with 5% minoxidil, PRP, and other growth factor solutions. Okay, results time. First, we'll look at the pictures with 7 weeks growth, which I'm honestly starting to favour because it gives a much clearer picture of hair thinning. The first picture is 7 weeks after day 0. I then let it grow another 2 weeks before shaving. So the third picture here is 16 weeks into the protocol. I cannot tell you how excited I was to see this picture. It looks like I have significant growth around the crown, and it gave me hope that this was actually working. My one hesitation was that these three pictures were in mid-March, late April and late June, and I spend a lot of time outdoors, so I wondered how much of a factor my tan was in the results. Last month, my final progress picture delivered a bit of a gut punch at the end of week 25, as it shows even more thinning than day 49 in some areas of my scalp, particularly this region here. Switching over to the shaved head pictures, day 63 and 196 look almost identical, but again, this area here is possibly subject to more thinning. While I like the pictures with growth, it still seems subject to the way that my hair falls that day and apparently how tanned my scalp is, so I would say these results are inconclusive. It's also difficult to say how much hair I would have lost in those 6 months if I'd done nothing at all. So what's next? As of now, there are only 3 more things that I would like to test: Redenzyl, low-level light therapy, and amla oil. Redenzyl and amla oil are both natural plant-based solutions that are 5-alpha reductase inhibitors. I've also recently heard low-level light therapy described alongside finasteride and minoxidil as a proven solution for hair loss. It would be an expensive one-off purchase and slightly more involved than taking a pill or using a topical solution, but right now I would settle for something that works and doesn't threaten to stop other parts of me working. I also feel hopeful that I could revisit rosemary oil, but applying it twice daily at 12-hour intervals and potentially achieve some growth. However, what I've chosen for my next protocol is amla oil. This 2012 paper looked at 17 plant-based solutions and found that amla oil, derived from Indian gooseberry, was the second most potent 5-alpha reductase inhibitor behind safflower. I couldn't really see hair growth products containing safflower oil, which is why I opted for amla oil. There was a 2017 paper that looked at a blend of 6 herbal extracts, which they gave the catchy name DA5512, and found a 5% solution of that comparable to 3% minoxidil in mice, as well as in human subjects after 16 weeks. For reference, the six extracts were green tea, amla oil, Japanese pine, kudzu vine, tribulus terrestris, and ginger. Aligning my methods with the rosemary oil paper, I will be applying amla oil twice a day at roughly 12-hour intervals. I've found it relatively scentless and discreet so far, unlike other solutions like peppermint oil, where my wife could smell me before I'd entered the room. I will be dropping microneedling for this experiment. Effective or not, it hurts. It leaves redness and bleeding, and I can't see myself doing it every week for the next 10 or 15 years, so it's not a long-term solution. Finally, after seeing the variation in progress pictures across the 28 weeks, I tried to find out if hair thickness has natural peaks and troughs. It seems that if a treatment is effective, you will see increased balding around 8 weeks. This is the hair shedding to make room for new hair that is thicker and stronger. I will be following this for an initial period of 6 months. If at 6 months there's no clear sign that it's thinning, I will continue for a further 3 months and I will repeat until I get a definitive answer. For anyone else out there conducting your own experiments, I would strongly advise you to consider the exposure period of your treatments. Even something as simple as saw palmetto is said to be more effective if taken as 2 to 3 smaller doses across a 24-hour period compared to one single daily dose. And that is due to the short half-life. The same could be true for something like scalp massage, and it seems like twice a day is a more effective cadence for a lot of these treatments. Thanks for watching.